Hello everybody, this is MoSanity, and today I'll be doing a map review of the Lumen Power Challenge. Now I'm going to review and summarize the overall idea, themes, and gimmicks of this map. So without further ado, here's the Lumen Power Challenge's map review. Now you might be wondering, what is the Lumen Power Challenge? Well basically, the Lumen Power Challenge is a map dedicated to educating people on electricity and the way it's made. So if you're looking for a nice educational map that you can maybe use to teach a couple of people, maybe your children, your friends, and other people that need educating, then this is the map for you. Now there are 5 different challenges you can play, which ultimately unlocks a big quiz at the end. Some of these challenges include using an elytra to fix some wind turbines, unclogging a dam by killing some shulkers in said dam, and fixing some solar panels. These challenges are located near red beacons which have pieces of information near them about the corresponding energy source. Being honest, I'm not the biggest fan of this idea, but they have executed it very well. Overall, I give the idea of the map an 8 out of 10. Because they turned a very mediocre idea into something that is actually very enjoyable. Now, onto the aesthetics. Now, I'm going to commend this map because this map has done something that most other map creators really don't do, and that's every building they have made in this map actually has its own purpose. So I congratulate this map for doing something that not many map creators do, and that is, well, fill the map with buildings to cover up the emptiness of the map, because this map's adventure really just takes away from that emptiness. It just adds something to the empty, is that a word? De-empty the surroundings. And where they have built, they have absolutely nailed the architecture with all the shapes. The palette is actually really good, and there's really nothing that takes away from the map. The only real downside to this map is, well, the emptiness. I do sound hypocritical in saying this, but there's some parts in the map where the emptiness just makes it a little bit awkward to look at. But other than that, the architecture is really, really good, and the aesthetic they've pretty much absolutely nailed. For overall aesthetics, I give this map a 9 out of 10. Mainly because there's not much noise in the map which takes away from the adventure in most maps, which is something that's rare to see in most adventure maps. But this simplicity is kind of the downfall of this map, and is why it's not a 10 out of 10 and I gave it a 9 out of 10, because in some areas it does look a bit awkward. Now onto the actual functionality of this map. Now this map aims to be an educational adventure map, which during this lockdown time is actually very helpful. As an educational map, this map actually succeeds, as the quiz at the end to finish off the map requires you to know about these subjects. Now, as an adventure map, I wouldn't quite say it succeeds. In my book, at least, to count as an adventure map, it needs to fit 2 criteria. The first of these criteria is that there are goals within the map to complete. Normally in order, but sometimes there are exceptions. This map you can make an exception. Now, for the second criteria, this map does not follow it. An adventure map normally needs a narrative. So unless there's some secret hidden lore that only map pack can find through counting toes or fingers of robot chickens, then I just don't see a story of some sort. Now, you may argue that this map doesn't need lore. It is supposed to teach people about electricity and how to get it. Well, then, it really wouldn't be an adventure map, which I believe is what this map is trying to advertise itself as. So, really, I'll just class this map as an educational mini adventure map. Mainly because it's not really an adventure if there's no narrative. That's like I go to my grandma's house and she asks me to do a bunch of chores. And I say, oh, that's a pretty neat adventure, isn't it? You can see how bizarre and stupid that sounds. But this map is just that, just taking it to levels that make it look like it's an adventure. When in actuality, you're just doing somebody's chores. I'll rate it a 7 out of 10 for functionality. Mainly because some of the challenges are a bit too long, which kind of slows down the pace of the map. Some prime examples include the coal generator and the hydro dam. Overall, this map is educational, meticulously designed, and has some ups and downs. And so overall, I rate this map an 8 out of 10. That's all for this time. If you enjoyed map review and wanted to become an official series on the channel, like and subscribe and comment what the next map should be.